boys started out on a journey, trying to sing out their soul of salvation. Christian God Almighty. And ever since that beginning, you know life hasn't been easy. But if you would ask me, how is it with me tonight? How is it with me this day? I would say, I'm leaning on Jesus. Did you hear me? I said, I'm leaning on Jesus.
Welcome to another Wednesday in the Word. I pray that you and your family are well, that you're blessed, that you're experiencing all of the love, the joy, the grace, the peace, the healing. I pray that you're experiencing every blessing that God has in store for you, because God is great and He is greatly to be praised. I certainly hope and pray that you and your family are enjoying this season. This spring season, this season of resurrection power, this season of getting up from where you are, this season of just being all that God has called you to be. Man, listen, tonight I want us to get our Bibles, get our smart devices, get our notepads, and we're gonna go back to what I consider a familiar passage of Scripture. It's one of my favorite chapters or portions of the Bible, and that is in the book of Joshua. Joshua chapter 1, and we're going to see what God says. I believe He's got some information in His Word that's going to encourage us, enlighten us, and help us to be the best person, best son, best daughter of God that we could be. While you're getting Joshua chapter 1, let me breathe a word of prayer and ask God's blessings on our time. Will you bow with me? Father, we thank you and praise you for this another day that you have, God, brought us through up into this present moment. We thank you for being our Lord, our Savior, our King, our provider, our protector, our healer. You have been everything that we need and so much more. We thank you, dear Lord, for this opportunity that we could gather virtually, God, to share your word with your wonderful people. Now, dear Lord, tonight I pray that you will forgive sin, heal bodies, encourage hearts, give direction to your people. Now speak to us and speak through us, and I give you thanks and praise now in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. All right. As I mentioned, we are in this season. For those of you who have been with us on Sunday mornings, you know that we've been talking about in this Eastertide season, this season of resurrection. We celebrate the resurrection of our Savior, not just on what the world labels as Easter Sunday, but we celebrate his resurrection every day and every week that we come together, because it is because Jesus got up that you and I can get up too. Can you say amen to that? We can get up from so many of the things that we go through because of the power of God, and because he is our Savior and our Lord. God doesn't want us staying down and not fulfilling the purpose and plan for us, but God wants us to get up and to move forward so that we can accomplish all that he has set forth for us to accomplish in our lives that will bring glory to him. Amen. So that brings me to the book of Joshua. Joshua is, as I mentioned, one of my favorite books in the Bible. And tonight, I just want us to kind of look at chapter 1, and we're going to begin reading at verse number 2 through 9. And we're going to highlight a few things, some things you may already know. But let's just see how the Spirit speaks to you. And as he speaks to you in places in your life that may help you move forward, that may help you with some prayers that you've prayed, giving you some direction, I believe the Holy Spirit is just going to speak. So jump in with me, Joshua chapter number 1, beginning at verse number 2. Joshua chapter 1, beginning at verse 2. Here goes the reading of God's word from the New King James Version of the Bible. Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise and go over this Jordan, you and all this people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I said to Moses. From the wilderness of this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and to go to the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give to them. Only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of a good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Can you say amen? All right, let's take a deeper dive. Let's take a deeper dive as we think about where we are in life. I understand and I recognize that there are some places that you and I cannot get to until we get up and get over some things. Let me try it again. There are some places and some accomplishments. There are some victories that you will never accomplish as long as you stay down. But I believe as we get up and as we get over, get past, get through some things, we will then move into our land of promise, our land of victory. that's somewhere or somewhat of this story of Joshua. This story of Joshua comes at a time when Moses, who had led the children and was God's, you know, man that he used for some time, had died. And now here it is, Joshua is coming into a place where he is now to lead God's people into the promised land. The problem that they faced was the promised land was before them, but the Jordan River was in front of them. And they had to get past this Jordan. They had to get over this Jordan in order to go into the promised land. Many of us, if we were to stop and to think about our life, some of us, we know that God has something in front of us. We know that God has made promises. God has given vision. God has given direction. God has, blessed you to know that there is something before you. But the challenge that we face is dealing with that obstacle, dealing with that challenge, dealing with that thing that is in front of us. The people of God were on the other side of the Jordan River. This Jordan River was a river that descended and it flowed. This Jordan River has been measured to be about 70 miles in length. Can you imagine? 70 miles in length, but because it was a windy and zigzaggy flow coming down, the pattern of it, it weaved for about 200 miles. So you get it really in length, it's 70 miles long, but because of the weaving and because of the terrain and how it went, it actually was about 200 miles as it weaved. The Jordan River, it was located, the Jordan River was located and it was north, like the mountains are up, and it flowed down from the Sea of Galilee and it would come down and it would flow all the way down and it ended at the Dead Sea. The challenge that the people of God had to deal with is in order for them to get to the promise of God, they had to get across this Jordan River. If they were to get in it and try to get in a boat and flow all the way down, they'd end up at the Dead Sea. But they didn't need to do that. They needed to get up and they needed to get over it in order to get to their promised land. But the first thing that the Bible tells them that they needed to do in order to get over it is they had to first get up. That's what verse 2 says. The Bible says that Moses, the servant, is dead. And here's the instruction that God says. Arise, go over this Jordan. Stop right there. I want to encourage you in this little lesson tonight. Not a long lesson. May I encourage you, my brother and sister, to get up. I've encouraged you. I've shared with you what God has given to me, that in order for us to get to some things, we have to first get up. We have to get up from some things. We have to get up from our heaviness, get up from depression, get up from the woe is me, get up from somebody else, you know, kept me from it, get up from excuses. You have to arise. Child of God, that is the word for somebody tonight. In this season that we're in, I just really feel the urgency of God to encourage you to get up. You have been down long enough. You have cried long enough. You have been overwhelmed long enough. You are a son or a daughter of God. And listen, greater is he that's in you than he that's against you, he that's in the world. So may I encourage you to arise. Somebody type that in the chat. Arise. The Bible says that God had told them to arise. They had to get up. Throughout scripture, we see, and Lord willing, we'll keep talking about it, where God instructed his people, you know, to get up. I shared with you on this past Sunday in the book of Acts, chapter number 26, where Saul had been knocked off of his beast, but God told him to arise. arise. When you get an opportunity to look in Mark chapter number 2, around verse number 9, there was a man who had been sick with palsy. He had been sick with palsy, and his friends had to cut open the roof and lowered him down before Jesus. And Jesus, seeing this man, he tells him, "Listen, son, your sins are forgiven." Then he tells him, "Arise, take up your bed and walk." The Bible says in Mark chapter number 5, there was a damsel, a little girl who had been dead. And this damsel who had died, Jesus put everyone out of the room. He then goes up to the little girl and whispers in her ear, "Talithai kumai," which means damsel, arise. And the Bible says that sure enough, this young lady got up. Can I encourage you, my brother? Can I encourage you, my sister? I know that it's been a heavy season. I know that it's been challenging for you, but thank God for His grace. Thank God for His mercy and the word of the Lord for you. Yes, you know what's before you, but you got to deal with what's in front of you. And before you can do that, you must first arise. Arise. Yeah, you blew it. Thank God for grace and mercy. You can repent of your sins. God will forgive you and you can arise. Arise. It's time for you to get up from what's been keeping you down. The next thing as we look at this scripture is they had to arise because they had to get over this Jordan River. You have to get over what's in front of you. You have to get what's over or get past that thing that's keeping you from the promise of God. Can I tell you something? God has already orchestrated and ordained your victory. It's already done. You and I just have to get in tune with God and fall in line with Him and obey what He tells us so that we can obtain our inheritance or our victory. I'm jumping ahead of myself. So you got to get up. You got to get up. And then you got to check out what's in front of you. What is that thing that is in front of you? When you recognize what that challenge is, it may be a coworker who's holding you down. It may be, you know, you got to finish your business plan in order to get past this. Get up from it. You may have been knocked down. People may have told you no, but you get up anyway because God has given you something. It may be a disappointment from a relationship, a marriage, a heartbreak. But child of God, can you get up? When you get yourself up, that thing that's in front of you, you now have to get past it. You now have to get over it. You now have to get through it so that you can obtain what God has in store for you. But God then gives some instructions. He makes some promises to them. He says, you know, every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given to you. Just like He had said to Moses, just like God has made promises to many of our forefathers, our grandparents, our parents, God has made promises. Listen, and you, ma'am, you, sir, are probably a part of those promises that God has made. I would imagine that somebody prayed for you and here it is. God is blessing your generation, blessing your children and your children's children because you're a part of that promise. You're a part of the plan of God. But in order for you, listen, where everything that your feet, every place that your sole of your foot will tread, all of these promises that God gave to them, it never took place, or it would have never taken place had they stayed sitting down, had they not arisen from what had been holding them down. My brother, my sister, tonight, I'm almost where I need to be. I need to encourage you to arise. Get up. Get up from where you've been. You've been down long enough. There's something before you, but now you arise so that you can get over what's in front of you. God then tells him, listen, this is how you're going to get over it. This is how you're going to get over that thing, that barrier, that weavy thing, that long thing in front of you, that if you don't get past it, you'll end up going all the way down and it's nothing but the Dead Sea down there. You have to be strong and courageous. That's how you're going to get over it, being strong and being courageous. That word strong is the word, it means that to fasten upon something. You have to seize it. You have to take hold of it. You have to say, listen, if God said it, if God's word says it, I'm holding strong to what God said. And I'm going to not only do that, but I'm also going to be courageous. That word courageous is the word that I'm going to pay attention. I'm going to grab hold to what God has said. I'm going to grab hold to his promises. I'm going to be strong. I'm going to get up. I was weak before, but thank God for his strength, because the Bible lets us know that his strength is made perfect in my weakness, in your weakness. So I'm going to take the strength of God. I'm going to be strong, and I'm going to be courageous. Listen, as you face whatever you deal with, that's what he says in verses 6, 7, and 9. He tells them that they have to be strong and courageous. Let's just read it. Be strong and of a good courage, for to this people you shall divide an inheritance to the land which I swore to their fathers to give to them. Verse 7 says, only be strong and very courageous. Jump down to verse number 9. Here's what he says. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage, and do not be afraid. Stop right there. Listen, you, ma'am, you, sir, in this season where you are rising, where you're about to get over what's in front of you, you got to be strong. You got to be courageous. You may get tired sometimes. You may get weary sometimes. But can I encourage you to stay strong? It may not look like things are happening at the speed or the time in which you think that it should get done. But can I remind you and encourage you to stay strong? Joshua was told, the people were told to be strong and to be very courageous. Child of God, God loves us so much that he knows that in our human frailty, many times we get weak, we get weary, we get tired. And when we don't have strength to hold our own selves up, we are held up on his promises. He holds us up. He strengthens us. The Holy Spirit within us gives us the ability to keep going when we don't think that we could make it another day. As you're going to get over this thing, as you're going to get past this so you can move into your promised land, you got to be strong. You got to be courageous. And as you do that, you understand that we do have an enemy who doesn't want to see us victorious. We have an enemy who he does not want to see you get up. He doesn't want to see you get over or get past this. He's going to do everything he can to stop you. But can I tell you, you have the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Man, that's some good news right there. You have victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let me tell you what the Bible says. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. 1 Peter tells us in chapter 5, verse 8, that you and I, as we take on the strength of God and the courage that God gives us, we are to be sober, to be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, is as a roaring lion, and he walks about seeking whom he may devour. But verse number 9 says something. Resist him. Resist the devil steadfast in the faith. Child of God, when that enemy comes against you like a flood, thank God that he'll lift up a standard. When the enemy tries to stop you, you can quote the word of God. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. When the enemy comes up to stop you, the scripture tells us that we can resist the devil. The Bible tells us in James, resist the devil and he will flee from you. But you can only resist him when you walk in the strength of God and walk in the courage of God, stand on the word of God and the promises that God has given you, because you've got to get to your promised land. But you cannot get to your promised land if you don't get past this Jordan River. You got to leave from this Egypt. You got to leave from this place that you've been down and get over the challenge in front of you to get to your promised land. Are you there? Here's the last point, and I'm on the freeway. Listen now. So we understand that we got to arise. That's what God told Joshua. He says, Joshua, you got to get up. You and this people, Remember, I shared with you all that many times God connects people to us and your family. As you get up and as you go over, your family that's connected to you, they're going to come over. As you get up, people on your job that may not know, you know, how they're going to get through certain things. As you go over, they're going to go over. As you in your ministry, many times as you walk and maybe somebody else may not understand it, but you as a leader, you as a man of God, you as a prayer warrior, you in your neighborhood, as you go forward in the promises of God, those that are connected and are part of the promise that God has assigned to your life, they're going to go over with you. And listen, they're going to receive an inheritance. Are you still there? Here's the last thing I want to share with you, child of God. Joshua is told to be strong and be courageous. And just like God was with Moses, here's the blessing. He promises to be with you. In this season that we're talking about arising, as we're encouraging you, the people of God, to get up, you, the people of God, to do what God has instructed you to do. The scripture tells us Joshua was told, listen, when you get up, you got the book of the law. You have God's word and you meditate. You chew on God's word. You see what his instructions are. You see what his promises are. And you and I were told, In the word, he says, don't turn from it to the right hand or to the left. As we stay the course, as we arise and we follow the leading of God, as we go over our Jordans to get to our promised land, there are some promises and some great things in store for us. And here's one of the best things that ever happened is that we know that we're not going over it alone. We're not going through what we're going through alone. We're not arising in our own strength. We're not getting through this Jordan by our own power, but we're going through it because God is with us. I just want to remind you, ma'am, I want to remind you, sir, that God is with you. If you're a born again believer and Jesus is your Lord and Savior, can I tell you, God is with you. That's the promise that he made to Joshua. Chapter number 1, verse number 9, he says, have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. That's my little lesson tonight, that you got to remember as you get up in this season of encouraging the people of God to get up. This season of encouraging you, people of God, let's get what God has for us. Let's move to be where God wants us to be. We've got to obey his word. Yes, absolutely. Obey. Don't turn from it to the left or right. We've got to cross over those things and we got to be strong and courageous. But here's a great thing that we understand. God is with us. God is with us. He made a promise. Here's what he said. This blessed me. He says, I will never leave you. Nor will I forsake you. That blesses me. God made another promise. He says, listen, I will be a very present help in times of trouble. Man, that blesses me. He let Joshua know. Joshua, sometimes, you know, in our humanity, things can be overwhelming. Sometimes things can cause us to be fearful or to be a little frightened by it. He says, don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. Here's why. For the Lord your God is with you. And not only is he with you where you are, but he's with you wherever you go. Wherever you take those steps, God is with you. As you go on that job interview, God is with you. He's with you as you go down, to graduate from school. He's with you. As you go in for that job, he's with you. As you got to go to the court or go to the doctor, he is with you wherever you go. It may be tough, but here's what you rely on. God's word. He says, I'm with you. Tonight, my brother and sister, that's the word I want to share. In order for you to get to your promised land, in order for you to receive the blessings and the things that God has for you that are on the other side of your Jordan, can I encourage you to arise? Can I encourage you to get up? get up, wash your face, clean it all up, put you a little Vaseline or Nivea or Vaseline intensive care, whatever you put on, wipe it up, put you some lip gloss on, some Vaseline on your lips. You do what you do, but you get up and you say, today is the last day that I've been down. I'm now going to get myself up. I'm going to get over this thing and I'm going to move forward into the promises that God has made for me. You'll never get to your promised land as long as you stay in Egypt. But you got to get up. You got to cross over this Jordan in order to get to your promised land. Is that all right? Father, I thank you that I've shared with your people what you've given to me. And dear Lord, I know that some of us have been in a season that it seems like we've been overwhelmed, we've been down. But I thank you for your word that you have once again instructed us to arise. Tonight, I pray for my brother and sister that you will give them the grace, the strength, God, to get up. Get up from what's been holding them down. Get up from every negative word that's been over their life. Get up from the people that have been trying to keep them bound and down. Get up, dear Lord, and God, that they will just have the strength and see, God, what it is you have for them to see in front of them and see what's before them, God, and get through what is in front of them. Whatever their Jordan River is tonight, whether it be a sickness, whether it be a disappointment or heartbreak or pain, I pray by the Spirit of the living God, Lord, that you will give them the grace and strength to get past it, to get through it. I pray that no one, God, ends up down at the Dead Sea. But Father, tonight that we're going to get over this Jordan River, we're going to get past this problem, get past this disappointment, get past this pain so that we can move into our healing, move into our deliverance, move into our peace, move into the promises that you have for us. Now, dear Lord, give us strength as we, God, we deal with some enemies. We have to deal with some devils and evil spirits, but we thank you that you told us that, dear Lord, greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. You told us if we resist the devil, that he will flee from us. You told us to resist him, though steadfast in the faith. You told us to be sober and to be vigilant because our adversary, the devil, is like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. I pray that you give us the wisdom, give us the discernment to recognize the traps of the enemy. And dear God, I thank you that you've already given us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord to get past him, to get over these things, to move into the promises of God. Now I pray your blessings on your people. Encourage, heal, strengthen, direct. God, bless them to be a blessing. I thank you that they're getting up. They're getting up from these challenges tonight. Father, we're getting up with new life and new power. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus who made the way for us to get up. And for this, we thank you now in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. All right, my brother, that is my lesson on tonight. Arise, get over what's in front of you, and go into your promised land. Because remember, you got to cross the Jordan River. You got to get past this side that they were on. You got to get past all of that. You got to leave Egypt and all of that other stuff where you've been to get past this Jordan to move to the promises of God. God is with you. He told you to be strong, be courageous. And I know that he's going to be with you wherever you go. Amen. All right, that's my time tonight. Listen. Our announcing clerk is going to come with our announcements in just a few moments. But I want to say thank you so very much, Second Baptist, for being such an awesome church. Lord willing, we have a few things coming up. Those who have gotten the salt, we have our, what is it called? The Salt Festival. It's going to be May the 4th right here. And then on May the 5th is going to be Acts After Church Talks. We're going to be with Pastor Wayne Cooper on the first Sunday afternoon in May, having these after church talks, discussions and things that are going to help us understand not only things in the church, but the community in which we serve, how we can be better. It's going to be wonderful. Our Set for Life ministry, they do a wonderful job leading us. So there's going to be information where you can register to be a part of that. Amen. Listen, thank you in advance for your liberality, your obeying God and paying your tithes and giving your offering. We have some wonderful things in store. We're planning another, Lord willing, we're going to try to get on the bus and take another trip and go somewhere for all those who want to go and just have a good time. So listen, that's my time. Know that I love you with the love of the Lord, and there ain't one thing you can do about it. And if the Lord should tarry his coming and the creek don't rise, I look forward to seeing you arisen on this coming Sunday, walking in the power of God right here at 10 a.m. God bless you. Have a great rest of the week.
The Love Life Celebration is Saturday, May 4th at Second Baptist Church from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. You can register now by scanning the QR code. You are invited to After Church Talks on Sunday, May 5th at Lincoln Avenue Christian Church. You can register now by scanning the QR code. For more information, visit setforlifenews.org. If you, a spouse, sibling, parent, son, or daughter is currently on active military duty, Second Baptist wants to acknowledge and express gratitude on Armed Forces Day, Sunday, May 19th. Active duty includes serving in the National Guard or Reserves. Please send the information to 2bcmonrovia@gmail.com by May 13th. If possible, please include a recent photo. All Nations Church presents women's health and well-being across the continuum. This event is on Sunday, April 28th, from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. You can also watch the event on Zoom. Monrovia Area Partnership presents the 14th Annual Neighborhood Conference on Saturday, April 27th from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. at Second Baptist Church. Happy anniversary to Jermaine and Melanie Matthews, Pastor Barack and Lady Diane Celine, and Woody and Geneva Douglas. May God continue blessing your unions.
Visit the SBC bookstore to purchase our specially designed SBC greeting cards. Your donations are greatly appreciated for the SBC clothing and toiletry drive.
TIP meets every second and fourth Sunday on the second floor of the Fannie M. Goodwin building. The SBC nursery opens at 9:30 a.m. Sunday school is virtual and in person, Sundays at 9 a.m. Please send your SBC pictures and videos to secondsnewsletter@gmail.com, or you can tag us in your social media posts at 2BC Monrovia. The Brotherhood Layman League and United Women's Fellowship Guild book clubs meet Mondays at 6:30. If you are either experienced with or want to learn presentation software, graphic design, content creation, video editing, or video streaming technologies, the media ministry needs you. We will train willing workers. Our mission is to support all church ministries in getting the word of God to those outside the four walls while representing SBC in excellence. Email us at 2bcmonrovia@gmail.com to find out more. If you're a married couple, please submit your wedding anniversary date to the church. SBC's Pantry Ministry meets every Tuesday from noon to 1 p.m. If your ministry has announcements, send them to 2bcmonrovia@gmail.com. The announcements must be received by Monday at 5 p.m. to air during Wednesday and Sunday services. It is better to give than to receive. There are four ways to give at SBC Monrovia. Men and women ought to always pray and not lose heart. If you want a prayer warrior to pray with you, text the word prayer to 626-495-3020. We will pray with you and for you. Thank you for watching our weekly announcements. Be blessed.